Good evening, baseball fans. You are tuning into Houston Astros Network, and once again, we are here at Minute Maid Park to see a matchup between the hometown Houston Astros and the visiting Tampa Bay Rays. Both teams are currently sitting atop their respective divisions, as the Rays enter this one with a 40-29 record, and the Astros with a very surprising 41-28. Well, let's take a look at the lineup Joe Maddon has assembled for his Tampa Bay Rays ball club. Leading things off, we have shortstop Hak-Ju Lee batting second. Also playing second is Ben Zobrist. In the three-hole, Will Myers, Evan Longoria cleanup, Wilson Bedemit in the fifth hole, and then the rest of the lineup lining things out. On the mound today for the Houston Astros is the young prospect Mark Appel, the 6'5 right-hander who is currently the number 2 overall prospect for the Houston Astros. He was a dominant right-hander at Stanford. He is their all-time strikeouts leader there. He profiles to someday be top-of-the-rotation starter for the Astros, and let's see what he can do here in his first Major League start. First batter Mark Appel is going to face in his Major League career is the shortstop Hak-Ju Lee, coming this one batting 295, 0 home runs, and 5 RBIs. Not the most productive of seasons, but he is batting 381 and only 263 against right-handers, so hopefully that'll fare well here for the young right-hander Mark Appel. And here's the kick, and the pitch from Appel, and that's right down the middle, 95-mile-per-hour fastball. Appel working with a 1-1 count here in Hak-Ju Lee. Here's the kick, and the pitch from Appel, and that one's just going to be slapped in the shallow outfield as the shortstop Torres is there to haul that one in relatively easily for the first out of the ballgame. Next up on the top of the first for the Rays, batting 278 with 12 home runs and leading the Rays with 48 RBIs is the second baseman, the utility man, Ben Zobrist, who has recently shown that he can be a Major League bat, which has solidified himself as a Major League starter. Here's the kick and the pitch from Appel, and that one's going to be down the zone, 94-mile-per-hour fastball, as Zobrist is going to swing and miss on that one. Here we take a look at the Tampa Bay Rays home run leaders. 15 leading the team is Evan Longoria, Zobrist and Joyce with 12 behind him, Myers with 10, Loney with 9, Wilson Bedemit with 7, and Logan Forsyth with 3 rounding things out. Now the 0-2 pitch from Appel, here's the kick and the pitch, and that one's going to be a high up and in fastball, 96 mile per hour as he strikes out Zobrist for his first Major League strikeout, and that is not a stat that Mark Appel is very... He's very used to seeing that, as he was Stanford's all-time strikeout leader. Now the 1-1 count on Evan Longoria, as he's going to rip that one into center field. And that one's just going to be an easy can of corn out there for Juan Pierre playing center today. Mark Appel starting off things very nicely here in his first Major League start for the Houston Astros. Let's take a look at the lineup now that Bo Porter has assembled for his Houston Astros ball club in this matchup. Leading things off playing center is Juan Pierre. Batting second and playing left, Alex Presley. Batting third and playing first, Kendry Morales. DHing in the cleanup spot, Chris Carter. And then George Springer right in the fifth spot. Pitching today for the Rays is the once highly touted prospect Jake Odorizzi, who is 2-4 on the season with a 4.50 ERA. Not the greatest of starts to the season, but he's looking to show he can contain Juan Pierre leading things off with a 256 average. The 0-1 count on Pierre. Here comes the kick and the pitch from Odorizzi as Pierre lays in a bunt. Now the catcher's able to get that one rather quickly and throw out the speedy Juan Pierre at first. Two outs in the inning, 2-0 count on Kendry Morales now. As here comes the pitch from Odorizzi, and Kendry Morales is going to chop that one right to the catcher. But the catcher's going to overthrow the first baseman. Morales is going to round first, and he's going to head into second standing up. But unfortunately, they weren't able to get anything going off of that, as that's going to bring things here to the second inning. Evan Longoria, the third baseman, leading things off here. He's 4-for-22 in his last 6 games, batting 182. He's only batting 243 in the season, but he does have 15 home runs and 35 RBIs, and that's what they're looking at of a man like Evan Longoria. And here's the 2-2 count, and the pitch from Appel, and that's a high fastball, 96 mile per hour, as he strikes out the star, Evan Longoria. That's 2 strikeouts already for Appel. Next batter up is James Loney. We've got 2 outs in the end. The 0-1 count. Here's the pitch from Appel. And that one's going to be lined past the third baseman, Todd Frazier. As Presley's going to get that one in quickly, holding the runner to first. 2 outs in the inning still, top of the second. 0-1 count here. As Appel's going to get that one a ground at the second. And that one's just going to be an easy out at the end of the inning here. George Springer leading off the inning for the Astros, batting .289 with 12 home runs and 34 RBIs. Very solid for the 19-year-old phenom, currently the number 3 overall prospect for the Houston Astros organization. Bottom of the second, 0-0 count. Here's the kick and the pitch. First pitch swinging. And that one's going to be lined, grounded into the outfield, excuse me. And that one's going to be a single for George Springer. Now we've got the newly called up Ronald Torres, who was batting 2-for-17 in his last 5 games with a .118 average. Not very solid on the season as he's batting .214 on the season, just over the Mendoza line. Man on second, two outs, 0-1 count here. Odorizzi, the kick and the pitch. And that one's going to be lined at the middle from Torres, and that's going to, runner's going to round third, head for home. He's going to slide in for the run. Springer gets a run. And that's a 1-0 ball game here for the Astros as they take the lead early on. Pick things back up in the fourth inning. Here is Chris Carter, the DH, and the cleanup man is up, who is 0-for-1 on the day. 1-1 count on Carter. Odorizzi getting set, and there's the kick and the pitch. And that one's going to be grounded into the outfield as the shortstop tries to get to that one in time, but that was into the outfield as that's a single for Chris Carter. Next batter up in the inning is George Springer, the rookie phenom. 0-2 count on him here, as here's the pitch from Odorizzi. He's going to ground that one to the third baseman, Longoria. He's going to throw to second, throw to first, but he's unable to get the runner at first as Springer beats that one out. And they've still got a base runner here, one out in the inning. As the newly acquired Todd Frazier is at the plate, 0-0 count, George Springer on first. And Frazier's going to rip that one to the second baseman, and that one is going to be an easy play, as Frazier doesn't have the wheels to beat that out like Springer does. Top of the fifth inning now. Mark Appel still on the mound, still going strong. 0-2 count here on James Loney. And that one's going to be lined to the first baseman, Kendrys Morales, as he's able to haul that one in for an out. Mark Appel looking very strong here, and a very strong Houston Astros pitching rotation this year, and pitching in general, as they are currently leading the American League in ERA, with a 3.36, not very far behind, are the Athletics with a 3.51, and the Rays with a 3.57, 0-1 count now. And here's the pitch from Appel, and that one's going to be lined over the head of the second baseman into the gap. That should be a stand-up double for the runner here, as they're able to get that one in rather quickly. But not quick enough, but they did hold him to only a double. Runner on second now, 0-2 count here for Appel. And that one's just going to be a ground out to Torres, the shortstop, as he shucks that one over to first. That's going to end the inning. Appel gets himself out of trouble there. Bottom of the fifth now, and the second baseman, LJ Hose, is up. Here's the kick, and the pitch from Odorizzi, as Hose lines that one into center field. That's a hard hit single into center. Hose once again having a very surprising season, as he's still hitting above the 300 mark, still shown he can be a very solid bat and a very solid glove in the lineup. Torreya's up now, 0-0 count, and he's going to be bunting here, as that's going to get Hose over to second, and there's no throw as Torreya's is able to get this first. Runners on first and second now in the inning. That's going to bring up Tyler Heineman, the catcher, 0-1 count here. Odorizzi with the kick and the pitch. And Heineman lines that one into left field. That's going to be a single. Runner's going to round third, head for home, and the throw's going to be offline, and he's not able to handle that one as the runner scores. And that's a 2-0 ball game now for the Astros. And we all got a runner on third and first now for Juan Pierre. And here's the pitch from Odorizzi as Juan Pierre is able to get that one right at the middle, but the shortstop's able to second. But Pierre is able to beat that one out, as the runner scores and makes it a 3-0 ball game now. Presley up now with two outs in the inning, 0-1 count, as Pierre was caught stealing. And Presley's going to jack this one to right field. That's back to the wall, and that is gone. Alex Presley, the left fielder. That is another surprising bat that the Astros have had this year. Really, the entire Astros lineup, the entire Astros roster has just been really surprising, as this team was not expected to be in first place at this point in the season, at any point in the season, to be honest, as that's a solo shot making it a 4-0 game from Alex Presley. Top of the sixth now, Appel's still on the mound, 0-1 count here. Ryan Hannigan is he's going to line that one in the right center. Pierre's going to give that one chase. He's going to get that one relatively quickly with his wheels. Get one that into the cutoff man. Hold the runner at second as Hannigan's not the fastest out there. Top of the sixth, still one out, 0-2 count here for Appel. And Zobrist is going to ground this one to the shortstop, Torres, but he's going to fire to first and get Zobrist out of first, but not before the run scores. And that's a 4-1 ball game now for the Rays, as the Rays have finally gotten themselves on the board. Bottom of the sixth now is Yoel Peralta is going to come in the game. He's appeared in 19 games with a 1-1 record, 2 saves, 2.55 ERA, 5 walks, 15 strikeouts, and 17.2 innings. He's going to be facing George Springer here with one out in the inning, 0-0 count. And Springer's going to be swinging. That's going to be a ground out the shortstop. Oh, Jacques Lee isn't able to haul that one in. That didn't really take a weird bounce. He just wasn't able to haul that one in. I guess he kind of rushed that one. So now we've got runner on first. Todd Frazier to the plate after the error on Jacques Lee. And that's going to be the runner stealing. And George Springer is going to get in that one easy. And he's going to head for third, but he's going to choose wisely as he holds up, as he wasn't able to get up and run for third as the ball was thrown in the outfield by the catcher, Ryan Hannigan. Todd Frazier wasn't able to do anything, and that brings up two outs, bottom of the sixth still for LJ Hose. George Springer on second. As Hose is able to jack this one into deep center field, but not deep enough, as that's just a can of corn out there in center. Top of the seventh now, Appel's still on the mound. James Loney to play it with one out, one man on. As he bloops that one over the second baseman's head, runner's going to head for third. And Pierre doesn't have the strongest of arms as he's not able to get him. That's going to be runners on first and third now. And after that, that's going to be the end of Appel's day. Very solid performance from the rookie, Mark Appel. Looking forward to a lot of big things from him here in Houston. As with that start, he showed that he is here to stay and he is here to dominate. As the Houston Astros crowd is able to give him a standing ovation. That's going to bring in Brad Peacock, who has appeared in 6 games, 0-1 record with 1 save, 1.72 ERA, 15.2 innings, 7 walks, and 13 strikeouts. So the first batter Peacock faces here. And that one's going to be lined to the third baseman, Todd Frazier, as he's able to jab that one. But he's not going to be able to get any outs, as he isn't able to get the throw off quick enough. And the runner's going to score from the third, and we've still got one out. Now man on first and second. Two outs now. Ryan Hannigan up, and he's going to line that one up into center field, and Pierre is going to gun home. But once again, Pierre doesn't have the strongest of arms, and the runner is going to score. Ryan Hannigan, there's an RBI single for him. 4-3 now for Tampa Bay as Hak-Ju Lee is at the plate. And he's just going to ground that one out to the shortstop, Torres, as he fires over to first. And that one's going to be an easy out to end the inning. But not before they strike for two in that inning and make it a 4-3 ball game. As Raul Valdez comes in for the Astros now, 25 games, 6-1 record, 4.91 ERA, 25.2 innings pitched, 7 walks, and 21 strikeouts on the season. That 6-1 record is really what's standing out here. As the first pitch he throws is a two-seamer down the zone for a strike one. 1-1 count now for Ben Zobrist. And he lines that one into center field as Pierre's going to get this one into the cutoff, man. But that's a single for Ben Zobrist. 0-1 count here on Will Myers as there's still a runner on first. And Will Myers is able to ground that one past the shortstop. And that's going to be a single for Will Myers as they're able to get a man on first and second here to start the inning. Not the greatest of showings from Valdez so far out of the bullpen. Zero outs, 0-1 count here. And that one's going to be flown out to Juan Pierre in deep center. He's going to throw into the cutoff man, but not before the runner advances to third. As that's going to be first and third now. And they're going to bring in a pinch hitter, Yunel Escobar. As they're going to go with the matchups here. Bring in Yunel Escobar, who is batting .228. One home run and 13 RBIs in the season. As here's the pitch from Valdez. And that one's going to be a strike down the zone. 0-1 count here now. And another pitch from Valdez. That one's going to be lined down the line if that's foul. 0-2 count now here. One out. Man on first and third. As that's going to be a ground right to the shortstop as Torres steps on second, fires for first. And that's a double play to get the Astros out of the inning. So they are able to get out of that one before any runs come across the plate as they keep their 4-3 lead intact here. Bottom of the eighth now, one out as Presley grounded out to start things off here. Peralta still on the mound facing the first baseman, Kendrys Morales. Oh, count here as Morales is going to line that one past the right fielder. This is going to be rounding first, heading for second here. The throw is going to be on time, but it's going to be off target as Morales is able to slide into second head first for a double. With that double, we're going to take a look at the American League doubles leaders. Indians with 143 with a decent lead there on the rest of the teams. Royals 125, and the Orioles and Astros tied for third with 122. Large part of that man right there, Kendrys Morales. Ninth inning now, you know what that means. The closer, Jesse Crane's going to come in the game, who's appeared in 25 games. 24 saves in the season, and that is going to lead the league, lead the American League with 24 saves. Not far behind him with 23 is the other closer here in Texas, Neftali Feliz. Now we've got two outs in the inning. Jesse Crane, 1-1 count. And that one's going to be a ground ball to Kendrys Morales as he's able to step on first for the out. And then the game for the Houston Astros, they come away with this one 4-3. Bo Porter there celebrating with his staff and his team, as he's got to be extremely happy with his Houston Astros ball club this season, as they are exceeding expectations beyond what anybody expected them to be doing. Two straight seasons, maybe even three straight seasons, I don't have the stat on the top of my head, but many seasons with just 100 straight losses and being one of the worst teams in baseball and just being an absolute joke, really. And they are coming to this one, and they are one of the hottest teams in baseball. Player of the Game award goes to the closer, Jesse Crane, who was able to come in the ninth inning as usual and shut down the Tampa Bay Rays lineup, sealing the deal for the Houston Astros and giving them a 4-3 win here at Minute Maid Park. And that's pretty much going to wrap things up here in the studio. Don't forget to take a look at the box score on your way out, and tune in next time here on Houston Astros Network.